Good afternoon all. This particular topic deals with the assessment of appropriateness of building windows within the campus, that is local climatic zone. And this is the lecture which is in the series of lectures which I have delivered earlier. And I expect the students to have the basic knowledge of windows functions as well as the climatic zone. So, in this particular lecture, I'll be dealing with various aspects. And to understand that, we should firstly brief about the functions of windows. The classical functions of windows obviously are the protection against the weather, daylighting, supply of fresh air and the connection to the outside. Yes, contemporary functions also include thermal and acoustical requirements, but depending upon their size, opening control, placement, shape, technical specifications, double glass, louvered windows, sliders, their appropriateness can be varied, can be judged and matters as per the different context in which they are placed. These are the different windows which depict their customization with respect to their proportions in terms of openings as well as the fixed sizes of the windows. Their opening position of the openings can be changed. The position of openable windows can be modulated. The portion of the fixed glass can be modulated depending upon the context in which they are used, and accordingly their appropriateness can be judged. Similarly, these are different windows which may be used in different climatic zones, and all these windows they have the constituents of openable portions as well as the fixed portions, different sizes as per the needs in different areas, different rooms, different buildings and different climates. Then their effectiveness can be judged, can be modulated, can be edited with respect to the location in which they are used. These are some of the examples where instead of conventional windows, we can have a mix of small windows for effective utilization of the space in terms of the climate. We can also modulate the window into different sun breakers in terms of different jolly networks, contemporary jolly network, which we also termed as Brysolyle and mostly used by Corbusier in the Chandigarh buildings and other contemporary building designed all over the world. These are some of the jolly networks or the perforations and fenestrations which have been used in the Mughal architecture, which were also very well used in different climates. These are some of the windows which have been in Chandigarh, where outer showcasing of the wall was also important, and this shading pattern of shade and shadows was also equally important. Here again, the fenestration in terms of Brysolyle was marked, and it has different purposes. It has a very contextual purposes with relation to the climate in which it is presented as a composite climate, where we have to welcome the winter sun and we have to avoid the summer sun, higher sun, the lower sun, as depicted by this diagram. Similarly, addition of water features in different climates, clearly the dry climates and the composite climates, can change the window functions altogether and can change the effectiveness of window openings for the indoor comfort as well. As far as this campus is concerned, where I'll be dealing with the students, this campus is Shri Mata Vaishno Devi University, which is located in the Katra part of Jammu and Kashmir. It's located in India. This climatic zone is essentially a composite climate zone, and I'll be taking my students before giving them a brief talk about the various windows, different windows in the various climatic zones. Now, under this activity, I am taking these students along with me on a round of campus where we are judging the effectiveness, appropriateness of the windows. Of course, maximum discussions and maximum inputs are there from the my side, and which will help the students to understand why such kind of designs have been used and what the pros and cons of such window designs. Of course, this campus has been designed by famous architects of India, and over a period of time, many reputed architects of India have worked in it in the phased manner. So window designs all over the campuses in different buildings of varied uses has been very effective and has been very good. So in order to understand it, we are taking this room. So as far as guidelines for the composite region is concerned in which this campus is present, we have to resist the heat gain in summer as we have the extreme winters and extreme summers. Also, we have to resist the heat loss in winters. We have to effectively use the promotion of heat loss in summers as well as the monsoons. So for doing that, we have to avoid externally reflected light from the ground and other external surfaces. We need to have the promotion of courtyards in the wind towers, and for that we should have the simultaneous arrangement of windows. trees and water ponds for evaporative cooling can also add to the indoor comfort. This is our own building where I teach my students of architecture on a daily basis. This is Department of Architecture Buildings, and already in this slide there are different kind of windows which have been used. This is a particular window which has been used in the faculty cabin, where lighting is a major consideration, and for the ventilation purposes we have these small openable windows at the accessible height from the ground. These are the glass louvers, and these are essentially placed towards the corridor side to promote the ventilation in the studios part where students work in large numbers and for the longer durations, and to promote extra light and the extra ventilations. All these faculty cabins as well as the entrance to the studios have been provided with the ventilators or the glass story windows. These are different types of windows which have been used at different places. These are windows which have been used in the classrooms and the studios, which is a three-part window. The upper part is essentially for the light, and the lower part is for the extra light, whereas central part is for the extra for the cross ventilation or the ventilation. Many of such windows have been placed on the northern side, which promotes extra light and which promotes a glare-free northern light for the studio's purposes, for the academic purposes, which is always the guideline for the academicians and the architects. Similarly, different sort of windows in different places in the corridors and the studios. As far as the external facade is concerned, we can very well see how the facade is broken and how the light shelves have been promoted, have been provided here. These light shelves are responsible for the fact that when the sun rays falls on it, it provides a reflected light into the interior, so that the heat of the sunlight is getting altered or is getting reduced. Simultaneously, these lower portions, when the sun comes down in the winters, the light can easily penetrate into the interior. So all these windows and the first floor projections with respect to the ground floor, these windows are extensively designed and very well designed, keeping in view the local climate. These are studio windows, which clearly depicts the penetration of north light into the studio areas. Similarly, all these are faculty windows, which is again a three-part windows for extra light and a small segment which are openable. This is studio window facing southern side on the first floor, and again it is recessed with the help of this massing, which is again taking the northern light, and again taking the winter light, winter sun into the interiors, where the summer harsh sun is cutting down. This is another building auditorium which has a more of a showcasing purposes. Simultaneously, these are some of the windows which have been recessed to take the lighting into some usable part of the auditorium, like various conference rooms, various boardrooms, and these are recessed to take advantage of the winter sun and whereas to cut the harsh summer radiations. These are the windows in some of the other buildings across different departments, where various windows are cut down by suitable massing in terms of porches, porticos, and such kind of light shelves or the sill projections and the lintel projections. And all these windows have been provided at different places. This is another approach where some serviceable components of the buildings are being heighted and simultaneously ventilation is promoted. It does not promote the ugly components of the building to get exposed to the surroundings, but simultaneously ventilation is not stopped. Other windows, these are the windows in administration blocks where lighting is a major need, so lighting is provided, and simultaneously a usage of air coolers and the air conditioners have been promoted by the suitable design of windows, and simultaneously a constituent proportion for the openable component is also provided. So basic architecture of the place, it is also promoting cross ventilation, the stack effect in different roof profiles, where we have a regular arrangement of the openings in the roof profiles as well, and different portions like the staircase portions, they are having long glazed windows to have the benefit of the light, majorly towards the northern region. And different parts of the buildings, as per their orientation and as per their needs, their windows have been designed appropriately. Some other approaches where windows have been broken, there are three parts windows, we have light shelves, you have louvers, you have recessions, you have this dormer kind of windows in the roofs. And these are the for the same climatic zone, these are some other buildings where this kind of arrangement of windows is there. This is essentially Bryce Lyle pattern, where again the summer sun has been cut, and to promote the indirect lighting as well as the ventilation, we have a window in the recessed portion. In some other portion for the sustainable material use and the for sustainable lighting, where only lighting is a problem, we can take advantage of the lighting by the use of some waste materials or the suitable materials, where you can have such kind of designer walls approach, where you can effectively use waste bottles also, where we can always take the lighting into the interiors, but simultaneously we are also promoting the use of waste materials, that is sustainable approach in architecture. For the same topics, there are many resources on the internet available, but the resources which I have referred from my internet and some other closed links related to my topic is hereby defined here, so you can always refer to these links as these very close relate to my topic. Thank you for your patience for hearing me. Thank you.